Do you want to know the definition of insanity? Do you get anxiety when closing your eyes in the shower? Or maybe you just enjoy when a gaming challenge goes Steve Rambo on your ass? If you said yes to at least one of these statements, then this challenge is for you. A surprise, to be sure, but a welcome one. Can you beat Kingdom Rush Vengeance without towers? This is a wearisome question to be asked. Surely a game that's called Tower Defense can't be beaten by simply making it a defense game. We have a lot to unpack here, so let's quickly discuss the rules. Rule 1. I can't build any form of tower in this run, or else I am disqualified. Notice that I say build, because I will allow the special towers. Two of them are barely even towers in the traditional sense, and Daddy got to have some fun too, okay?
What are you doing, step bro?
Rule 2. We are playing on impossible, because this game keeps surprising me with how easy it is. I came up with this mistake myself, so I don't know if it has been done before. However, a channel I found also have had this bright idea, but just in the first game. And it's in his honor that I therefore add this side quest. I have to beat levels, no lives lost, until I determine a level to be impossible to do this way. I am willing to admit that I might have gone too far this time. So if this all goes tits up, then you have War Champion to thank. Go and show him some love. If you do not end up enjoying this video, then make sure to drop a big fat dislike. I appreciate that. Also, we are not going to start a new game because I need to have access to the entire catalog of OP 80s action heroes. Will Bulgor make me grow an extra chromosome? Does this cutscene add to anything other than my pain? And does Icecult have a crippling meth addiction? Let's ready the fuck up and find out. On today's episode of Specimen of the Wizard Type, we are introduced to the Dark Sorcerer, Visnan. Nan here is a proud stay-at-home dad, and in his spare time he enjoys anti-monarchy practices. And even likes to invest a little in the local business community. Currently, he is leading an ongoing investigation in President Dennis' tax returns. Let's join him on a normal day in his life and see what it involves. As a little warm-up for my journey, I decided to help Vesnan clear Doofenshmirtz Evil Incorporated from anti-vax protesters who for some reason had shown up. And just to flex a little, I would like to add that I beat it with Veruk and nothing else. But enough fooling around, cause I had some heroes who needed to be leveled up. And my first pick was of course Icecult. Using this treebeard sounding motherfucker made my nipples hard, but not in a sexual way. This hero is definitely not in any way overpowered. No, they were hard because global warming did a 180 after this boy entered the arena. After this first level, past coziness was apparently feeling a little ballsy, because since the beginning of this challenge was going to be easy, he therefore decided that he had to unlock souls as he went along. Little did he know that he was going to regret making this decision. Anyway, level 2 was no match for Icecult, who straight up spit roasted every enemy that came into his proximity. And no, we are not going to talk about me losing already at level 3. Hey, fun fact, did you know that Icecult means ice cold in German? The more you know. Level 4, however, turned out to be a bit more challenging to beat, but after a couple of attempts, I got the job done. But due to the rules of this run, I had to investigate if this level was possible without losing any lives. 2 hours later, I came this close to doing it, and equally as close to flinging my monitor across the room. This level was beginning to tap into my inner Asperger's, because in some parts, this level literally requires Icecult to be two places at once. I really thought that this was the human max, but after many analyses of my recordings, I unfortunately found out that this was possible if only I played it perfectly. 17 lives? Okay, 18. Yeah, we're getting there. 18 again? Ha! You're starting to take the piss. 19? Well, that sucks. If you have not realized this yet, then I don't blame ya, cause I clearly didn't either before playing this. So I think that this is a good time to mention how fucking boring it is to play 12 minutes of killing little Jimbos with your hero just to get to the difficult part. Using Icecult in action for the first couple of hours made me grow a few extra inches, but it got pretty old quick and my dick was now starting to retract inside my body. But as I soon learned, this was a common side effect of doing a challenge like this. Anyway, I don't really have a good transition to this, and you've probably seen the full run earlier in the this timeline, so victory was achieved. If a weird crossover involving midgets and torture porn is one of your many fetishes, then I suggest you go fetch the loop now, because oh boy, you're going to enjoy this one. I probably hold the world record for deaths on this stage. This level was a constant fight for survival. Just trying to stay alive on this one was even harder than perfectly completing the last. So no lives lost was completely out of the question. I decided to give Berizad a shot on this one. But I quickly retracted that idea when I was introduced to a new fuckboy, fresh out of the gym, who wanted to take my ass to the school dance on Friday. There was way too many of these for Berizad to do the good old hit and run trick on. You may think that this level would be easy since the two exits are right next to each other, but this is vengeance on you, and you are a big dummy idiot for even thinking that. The fact that Ice Cult had shown up drunk to work didn't help either. For example, when Ice Cult is hovering over a vertical path, it will cause a chemical reaction that makes him unable to use quadratic formulas to predict enemies' movements, giving him the aim of a James Bond villain's henchman.
Retardation.
This level was starting to give me nausea and a massive migraine. No matter my timings and decisions, I would always be ran down like an animal. Even talking about this makes me feel like shit. So let me just give you some of the highlights.
I got a pizza here.
It doesn't take a scientist in human behavior to deduce from these clips that I was nothing else than an insignificant piece of meat for exploitation to these dwarves. But this would all prove to be worth it though, cause after about 9 hours of tragic gameplay, I finally stood up for myself, and with one singular life, I was able to lock my way out of this situation. After all of that, I was finally given a break from all the sodomy with this next level. Everything was going swimmingly. I even caught an episode of Dictators while playing, but as most gaming challenges go, this was not meant to last. I want you all to remember that the chances of getting ran down by a Thrall cosplayer wielding only a Transformers chair are low, but never zero. I can't believe that it took me this long to realize, but I just now found out that I was a big dummy ham sandwich, because there was absolutely no way I was going to take this guy down on impossible. It's a lucky thing I mentioned in the rules that I could lower the difficulty on this day. Okay, I'll admit it. The boss fight had apparently slipped under my radar during my careful planning of this run, so I had to cheat a little to beat him. I know I failed the challenge right here, but I had already put way too much time, energy, and sanity into this run to turn back now. So I switched to casual, the difficulty for beginners and for stupid challenges that require diplomatic solutions. Unfortunately, Ice Cult didn't have enough spit for this big boy, so Merklin was now the new sexy. With her now in level 10, this boss battle would actually be possible. It would even be easy if it wasn't for the fact that my dumb rule of not using all 60 souls was in effect. There's a few advantages to Merklin that makes her superior to this buffoon. She has the highest DPS in the game, and even when the boss shrouds himself in the crowd, she can still drop her poopy diaper on his forehead. But wait, there is more. Her ult deals 460 damage per meteor, and it throws 5 on every cast. As long as I could hit 4 out of 10 meteors, this boss battle would be a done deal. However, that was easier said than done, cause they are thrown in a random pattern. And even if you get the pattern you want, you still have to aim it very precisely to hit more than one. The boss really thought he had the best of me, but he was wrong, because I had acquired a taste for pain. I was obsessed. I loved having to waste 18 minutes of my life just to get shin bashed in the dick sack cause of RNG.
Yeah! Woo! Yes! Let's go!
Later, I also realized that I had to make it to the boss with at least 20 lives in order to get enough time. Even the chances of me getting a girlfriend was higher than my chances of winning this. If there are any vets watching, can you please tell me what's wrong with my dragon? I feed him a healthy diet and he's not sterilized, yet he still fails to engage in sexual intercourse with potential mates. Two whole infinity wars later, and it was finally my time to shine. Before watching this clip, I want all of you to make sure that you have a fresh pair of panties next to you, because this gameplay is truly otherworldly. Did you know that Berizad means balanced in French? Well, that's why we're putting him on the shelf. Cause he didn't even work on this level, where his ult can one-shot every single enemy. So I flied over Ice Cult to do the dirty work. And it was here where I had to admit that I was wrong. Because beating this level without all the upgrades was literally impossible.
I've made a severe and continuous lapse in my judgment.
Wave 13 was improbable to survive, and wave 15 is even harder. So we are going to scrap this rule, which any sane human being would not have greenlighted anyway. Okay, so surely this level was going to be easy now. Well, No, it was the most luck-based shitfest I've ever had the displeasure of experiencing. God forbid you try to play Kingdom Rush Vengeance without towers, and even the easiest levels becomes the biggest obstacles. Upon seeing how close I got to the end of this attempt, I now knew that this was possible, and I therefore had no excuse to call it. But for me to even have a chance at this, I had to get back down with at least 14 lives or something like that. I'm just pulling numbers out of my ass. With mental health decreased,
are you taking the piss?
And ADHD medication increased, I threw myself at this again and again for I don't even know how long, and finally I have made it to wave 15 with the appropriate amount of lives, but I unfortunately outplayed myself here. I was nearing the 10 hour mark on this stage alone, and I was starting to feel even more side effects of doing this challenge, one of them being the urge to bend over and give in.
I tried, I did my absolute best. There's too many. There's too many of them, goddamn! I'm not dying for this shit, fuck that.
We all know that I deserve a beatdown, but come on, this was too much for even me. I wouldn't even wish this upon the scumbag who stole my Waylord glitter card as a kid. A little more cheating was done, but at this point I will just let it slide, cause seeing as we were already 35 hours in, I assume that past coziness was sick of all this torture. The problem of this run is not so much the difficulty. The problem is that it's dreadful to play every level for 8 to 10 hours with such limited options.
Trash! Fix the game! It sucks playing the shit!
Hey, I don't know if anybody has told you this, but god damn, you smell really good today. Did you start using a new shampoo or something? Anyway, after probably 3 mental breakdowns on that level, I raised my chin, rubbed my ass with some aloe vera gel, and queued up for more painstaking gameplay. This next level was going to give me a break, hopefully, because there was only one exit to worry about. I tried on impossible for like 2 attempts or something like that, but honestly, I had already cheated so much that I didn't even care anymore. I just wanted to see if this game was possible without towers at this point. The closest bit to an anime girl was introduced, and so was my artillery. But not that kind of artillery. Hey, guys, all in all, this level only took me 2 hours to beat, which I can't believe is considered a small amount of time. But in conclusion, get fucked.
Nigga, did I just catch you having fun?
In a world where coziness has completely dropped the cookies, there is one abnormally large kid who likes to stalk the school playground on the mountainside. Harry Dragon Rider McGee here does not know of moral authority and speaks the ancient language of violence. He seeks only to bully our autistic adventurer and steal his limited edition Lego Star Wars watch. A formidable opponent against the washed-up ice dragon who misses every single ice spike.
This level preaches Ironhide's political agenda on how the moon landing was all a lie. I tried this level on every difficulty, and the only one that seemed within the scope of this video was casual. Normal might be possible, but don't take my word for it, because I've been known to be slightly wrong on numerous occasions. With the introduction of these guys, this level was now even more AIDS. Nope, come on, ice card, move on. Hit, no, hit. Hit him! Worst of all is that enemies come scattered in small groups, so getting a recharge ult is next to impossible. This level also has 2 completely separate paths, and it just so happens that it is a fact that this issue is the number one reason why 100 delusional gamers get held hostage every year. If all of that wasn't enough, then there's also this hairy ballsack sprinkled on top, who drains your reinforcements health bars. I am sorry, but I can't take it any longer. I've spent over 40 hours on this, and it's taking too long. So this is where the challenge ends. This level is possible, but all of the previous levels super sucked all of the energy out of me due to me going overboard on the rules. I'll probably leave a Patreon down below or something, so you guys can help me pay for my therapy. So, can you beat Kingdom Rush Vengeance without towers? Probably yes, but I can't. I hope you can forgive me for this disaster of a run. If there is any daring souls out there who wanna experience an uncompromising loaf of dread, then you could pick the run up from here and finish it off, as this challenge is enough for one person alone. Or you could start from the beginning. But in any case, please do yourself a favor and play with all the upgrades. Judging by how this is looking so far, then the highest possible difficulty to complete this challenge on is normal. But you do you, and if you dust yourself, then send the video to me on Discord or in the comments. I would be honored. Anyway, I owe you a big thank for listening to all my bullcrap and rooting for me. Hope you're having a wonderful day. Kiss kiss and good night.
Didn't fucking think you can lay around my house all day. doing fuck all, you fucking sausage roll looking twat.